Now, should be have some video. Now, what little story, Glenn. Mm-hmm. What's this hand action you got there? What is that going on?
That's gold.
That's it. You like that?
There you go.
Yeah, now I interviewed you. Glenn, tell me, what made you take up golf?
Oh, it's just, I don't know, I was just always, well, my mates were down at the driving range, and since I can't see, I was just sitting in the back, just listening to them hit golf balls, and yeah, just said, come and hit a golf ball. I thought, okay. So I just started hitting golf ball one after another, and then 2008, I just started going to the range all the time, and 2010, I started playing around Australia and overseas.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah, there you go, guys. And like these blokes, you meet a few blokes too while you're on your journeys, eh?
Yeah, all the time.
What's been your highlight? What's been your highlight, Glenn?
August last year, me and the wife went to England to play in the British Open.
Wow.
And I ended up finishing runner-up in my category. So that's my biggest highlight. And I finished really well and just I enjoyed it all the time over in Canada. And then in 7 weeks, we go down to Nelson Bay, New South Wales, to play in the Australian Open and the World Championships.
When you say we...
The wife and I.
Your wife and you, and right next to you, you've got your good mate here.
Yeah. The eel superstar.
He surely was. And now he's helping you out in a lot of different ways on the golf course.
Yep.
Can you tell me a little bit about Mark and he's assisting you, you know, with your golf?
Well, he's the eyes. He's just telling me where to go, and I'm just on whatever distance he tells me, then I'm pulling the club and work as a team, and we do it Tukes' way.
Fantastic. Now, Mark, with your training of Glenn, what's been the highlight for you?
How it kind of got started. He heard me on the radio actually talking sport, and he rang in and got in contact with us about he plays golf blind, and I thought, no, it can't be serious. I play golf and I'm hopeless. And then we teed up a time to have a challenge, and I took him out, and since then we've formed a bit of a partnership, and he took me down to Adelaide one year, and we came second or third in one of those tournaments. So it's just to see someone who can't see do what he does is just, it's inspirational really.
And when you're out there with him, what's the thing that you most feel you help him with? What's the key things for you when you're out there as a caddy for a blind golfer like Glenn?
It's more keeping him relaxed. He's had a coach for a while, so his swings, he knows his swing. So that's the key, obviously, in golf. He knows what his swing is, and I just work with what club he's hitting well at the time, and we kind of stick with those ones. And more for me, it's more around the green. He needs me more. Describing how far and the slope, and then I aim him up for his putts. So that's me reading the greens, and him just relying on his stroke.
Brilliant. Now, some of the things are coming up for you. You were saying 7 weeks' time you're off into a tournament. Where is that again?
That's Nelson Bay.
Nelson Bay. Yep. And what's actually happening there? What event is it?
Playing in the Australian Open and the World Championship. So everyone internationally from around the world, 56 players are playing in the Worlds.
This is the World Vision Impaired Golf event? Is that what they call it?
Yep.
And the categories, all different categories?
Yep.
You might be able to, for the people who don't know, explain a little bit about those categories, because you can't see at all at the moment.
No, there's three different categories. There's a B1, which is total, which is me, then B2, which is, and B3, which are visually impaired. B2 can only see 2 to 3 metres in front of them, and then B3 are 3 to 4 metres in front of them. Mm. So there's just the different eyesight categories.
And with the rules of golf, of course, blind golfers have slightly different rules than
other golfers. The only rule difference between normal golf and blind golf is we get to ground our club in the bunker.
Oh, they allow you to.
Yep, yeah. That's the only rule, because we get to feel where the sand is.
Oh, isn't that brilliant? And with the scoring, what handicap have they got you on?
54. Yeah, way too much.
You can't even see a single ball or the course, and you go around in about 100 and a bit.
The lowest here I've shot was 2 weeks with Tukes, and I shot 110 off the stick.
Whoa.
That's me lowest.
Excellent. Well, I think there's better things to come for you too, and this is, by the way, without even using a pitching wedge.
No.
Whoa.
Don't want it, don't need it.
Hey?
That's me.
I'm going to play with you on that, because I can help you with that one. But no drama, that's me having a little go at you. But thank you very much, Glenn, and I'll come into the picture. I'll shake your hand. And we had fun here, and hopefully we can have some more. It was great.
Thank you.